Damascus, there was a sheikh known as Sheikh Misk. There was a sheikh known as Sheikh Misk. And I want everyone to listen to this story with the ears of their hearts. Right? Why was he known as Sheikh Misk? Misk is one of the most expensive and one of the most precious and one of the most fragrant, scents that ever you would ever come in contact with. Misk. Why? His name wasn't Sheikh Misk, but he became known as Sheikh Misk. Why did he become known as Sheikh Misk? One day, he was a humble man. One day he was at home and someone knocks his door. He opens the door and it was a lady. This lady forced her way into the Sheikh's house. This lady, what did she do? She forced her way into the Sheikh's house. And this lady was an evil woman. She was a evil woman. She forced herself into the Sheikh's house. And she said to the Sheikh, she locked the door, right? She was a tough woman and she was an evil woman. And she said to the Sheikh, either you commit haram with me or I will leave this house and mention to the people of the streets that look at what the Sheikh was doing with me. So either way, she wanted to corrupt the reputation of the Sheikh. She forced herself into the Sheikh's house and she said to him, either you do haram with me, either you have relationship with me and have haram with me, or I will leave this house and I will say to the people that this Sheikh, look, he forced me into his house and he wanted to commit haram with me. Now the Sheikh was a very pious man. He's stuck. What does he do? If he says no, she will go out of the house and ruin his reputation. If he says yes, he will commit haram. Both are equally bad for the Sheikh. So what does he do? He was a man of sincerity. He was a man of goodness. He wasn't a man who was going to give his religion cheap. He wasn't a lowly person. He was a person who had seen the Jamal of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was a person whose heart was captured by the absolute beauty of the Divine Jalla Jalaluhu. He was a person who would stand at night in the dark nights calling upon his Lord, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. He was a person when eyes would go to sleep, he would stand. He was a person when people would be eating and drinking, he would be fasting for the sake of his Lord. So what does he do? He said to the woman, he said, fine. He said, I'm ready. Just let me go to the bathroom. Let me go to the bathroom and I'll be back. What did he say? He said, let me go to the bathroom and I'll be back. It wasn't a quick exit. Listen to what the Sheikh did. He went to the bathroom and he relieved himself. He relieved himself. And what came out of his body, he placed it on his hand and he covered his face with it. He covered his face with what had come out of his own body. And he came into the room and the woman became furious and she ran out of the house. Because now she saw a man whose face was covered with that which had come out of his body. Then he went and he washed his face, and his face till the end of his life smelled like musk. Till the end of his life, his face smelled like musk. And I can swear by Allah that you know his grave also smells like musk.
والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أولئك أصحاب الجنة هم فيها خالدون.